let's make a start.
As anybody who went to grad school at Northwestern will recall, weekly colloquia, Fridays at noon and my day, were a time both for engaging intellectually and for observing closely those curious creatures, our professors. One of my favorite memories includes Art Stinchcomb, Carol Heimer, Arlene Kaplan-Daniels, and of course, Sandy. I can't recall who was speaking that day. As I just mentioned, grad students were as fascinated by faculty members' behavior as by the scholarship being presented, or at least I was. But I do remember quite clearly that on this day, per usual, Art and Carol had brought their homemade lunches in large mayonnaise jars, the clinking of spoons on glass for the first 10 minutes of the presentation, housed in their individual CNH sugar bags. It was always CNH sugar bags. Sandy, meanwhile, had brought in his meal from the nearby McDonald's. On the day I'm recollecting, Sandy was seated two chairs to the right of Arlene, who apparently also was hungry but had neglected to bring in any food of her own. As per her nature, Arlene was not shy, this time not shy about snacking from Sandy's portion, not so subtly reaching across the person who sat between her and Sandy and plucking French fries one by one from his serving. This is where the story gets very Sandy. Rather than silently enduring Arlene's French fry thievery, or perhaps making eye contact with her to tell her to knock it off, Sandy simply kept his gaze on the speaker and gently, but unmistakably, slid his fries a good foot further to the right. Thereupon, Arlene acted as if nothing had happened. And maybe nothing really had happened, just a little slapstick starring the faculty as the faculty, but it produced great hilarity for me, Judith Levine, and Mitchell Stevens, with whom I debriefed at length after the colloquium. Metaphor for Sandy's style with his students and his colleagues. Pretty damn straightforward, but pretty damn kind at the same time.
He looks like James Dean.
Sandy Jencks taught my mom economics.
Thanks, Sandy.
Can I say you something?
As a co-author, Sandy is both rewarding and utterly infuriating. I first got to know Sandy Jencks probably when Sandy and Jenny invited me to come down to their place in Cape Cod when I was considering entry to the Harvard PhD program. I drove down and was greeted by Sandy, who immediately said, "Now, should we go for a swim?" So this most esteemed of professors who have written these amazing books that I thought was well above anything that I could ever imagine was suddenly stripping almost naked.
Many of us are great admirers of Sandy's important contributions to the sociology of inequality in education, but fewer are familiar with his very important senior thesis on the study of urns, an inquiry into intellectually ill visited the depository of Harvard senior thesis to consult this work before starting to explore symbolic classification systems. The senior thesis is, in fact, the origin of the concept of habitus.
Somehow I persuaded Sandy to read a chapter, and it came back in circle. I'd said that I had a new theory of something or the other at 19, and Sandy wrote in the margins, promise less, deliver more.
When Richard Daley, who was then Attorney General of Illinois, was threatening to subpoena my dissertation interviews in order to catch the so-called welfare cheats I was interviewing, Sandy learned from several law school professor friends that the certificate of confidentiality I'd gotten would ultimately protect me from prison, but only on appeal. So in mulling over the prison option with me, Jenny was quick to see the silver lining. She said, "You know, you could probably get a lot of good work done in there."
Scholarship, your mentoring leads me to say very sincerely that when I grow up, I want to be Sandy Jencks.